Welcome to UroChannel. Let's delve into a disease that affects the muscles of the penis. It is called penile fibrosis. My name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist. Yes, there is muscle inside the penis, but it is a special kind of muscle. The name? Smooth muscle. Basically, the penis consists of three tubes. Let's just focus on two of them. They make the penis rise with sexual arousal. They are called the corpora cavernosa. When the penis ages, muscle may get damaged. All tissues of the body need air. This is why we have lungs to breathe with. The lungs are the organ of the body where blood takes up fresh air. From here, the bloodstream transports it to the penis and all other organs. Problems arise when there is not enough blood supply. This can happen when arteries become clogged over the years. Muscle cells don't like that, and they will react by dying. The term penile fibrosis means just that. Muscle cells transform into connective tissue. Connective tissue is the same as scar tissue. But in contrast to the usual scar, fibrosis will go on. It doesn't stop. It's a bitter truth. Fibrotic tissue is lost forever. Medicine has no magic wand to repair that. So, what can we try? Save what's left. For example, by using Viagra or Cialis. This class of drugs makes more blood flow. More blood helps muscle to survive. At least, what is left of it. Sometimes, it is possible to retain enough function with this strategy. For sex, a vacuum constriction device may be used, or injections into the penis with Trimix or Alprostadil. If nothing helps, a penile prosthesis is the only option left. What does the future hold? Maybe stem cells, maybe gene therapy. What are stem cells? They are found in different locations in the body. And the beauty of them is, they can become anything. You take a stem cell, put it into the liver, it becomes a liver cell. You put it into the lungs, and it becomes a lung cell. You put it into the penis, and it becomes a penis cell. Stem cells are a very hot topic right now because they reduce fibrosis in animals. We are lacking data on humans because, you know, results from animals can't be directly transferred to humans. Stem cells in humans have been tried for erectile dysfunction, but only in few studies with low patient numbers. There are still many unanswered questions. Which stem cells are best for penile fibrosis? Because there are several kinds. You could take them from fatty tissue in your belly, or you could take them from bone marrow, or muscle, or even from urine. You could maybe even take stem cells from another person. You can imagine how difficult it is. There is still a lot of work to do. If you want to try stem cells for penile fibrosis, you will have to look for a clinical trial. I am not sure anybody is doing it outside a trial right now. However, the good news is no side effects have been reported so far. Because this is not a drug, it's material from your own body. What about gene therapy? Definitely not in the next 10 years to come. Scientists are working on it. There are advances in small RNA and small interfering RNA. If you don't know what that means, neither do I. It's so complex, you really have to work in that field to fully understand what they are doing. We will see what the future holds. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.